Arrest?
Yeah.
As in, like, being arrested?
Yeah. It doesn't have to be you, but a true story about someone you know. Anybody got a secret or an arrest story?
Yeah, I have.
Let's go. I'm going to be 2 minutes precisely.
2 minutes, right.
And then what I'm going to do is, we're all going to listen to this story, we're going to steal it, okay? Is that okay for you?
Yeah.
Great, let's go.
Okay, so a close friend of mine who I've known since I was 7 or 8 has been watching illegal pornography in his house for a number of years, and he one day was downstairs with his 2 children and his wife, and the police knocked on his door and came in and spent some time telling him why he was being arrested, and then they took him away on 3 o'clock in the afternoon, put him in a van, a load of other people, drove for about 24 hours, didn't know where they were going or what was going on, and ended up in Bristol prison. About 24 hours later, kind of demobbed, given not very much information, and then kind of someone who he was with, he knew and said that in order to survive in here, do this, do this, do this, do this, and don't do that, and you'll be okay for the next 3 days, which he did, and he's still there now, and so there's a trial coming up and stuff. And that might be about 2 minutes.
Then we've got half a minute again.
So there's lots to this story, but he has got to plead guilty to a number of charges, and he doesn't want to plead guilty to the last charge because it doesn't relate to what he sees that's been going on. I went to visit him in prison last week, and he said, "Duncan, you know, it was a relief to be caught. It was a relief to be caught."
Brilliant. And there we go.
So for Valentine's Day, I made him this box of heart-related paraphernalia, and one of the things in the box was one of these pop warmer things. You know, they've got like a liquid in them, and then you push on it, and it like gets warm. Anyways, yeah. So these things you have in your pockets for winter days, and he really liked it. He didn't really like anything else in the box, but he really, really liked that. And then when the day that we broke up, I had a gig, and I think he kind of knew the conversation we were going to have after the gig, and he arrived, and at the end of the gig, we sort of didn't really speak much, and then he put this thing in my hand, and it was a pocket warmer, which had gone hard and didn't heat up anymore when he pushed on it, and I felt really awful about it, but at the same time, it was kind of a relief to have it back.
Still with you for 45.
But then the funny thing was, I started to perform this story, and I kind of wrote like a monologue out of it, and I kind of did it so many times that it sort of lost its connection to the place that it had happened, and subsequently I became friends with this ex-boyfriend. And I was running an event last year, and we had a launch, and I invited him there, and he was acting a little bit strange, and I couldn't really figure out why. And towards the end of the evening, he sort of said to me, he's like, "You know, I'm really glad that we're friends again, but I thought it was kind of weird that you invited me to a place where we split up." And then I realized that this was actually the bar where I'd had this gig 4 years ago and had given him the popcorn back, but I told the story so many times that it just kind of became the story I told, and it wasn't really connected specifically to that place or even him and me.
I have a friend who was involved in quite a lot of things that he probably shouldn't have been, and one of his big main secrets was that he dressed up as a woman. And he loved dressing up as a woman, and he danced around in women's clothes. And I connected with him quite quickly with this woman aspect of it, to the point that we kind of shared a similar thing with this hearts, with the hearts, and we exchanged heart-like things. I think one of them he gave me was a pan warmer type thing. something that we exchanged. And he gave that to me at some point, and we both had one, we both kept it at the same time. And this secret was kind of going on, and he tried to like steal some of my underwear, borrow some of my underwear, which I kind of sometimes leave behind for him, because I knew that he might kind of like that kind of stuff. And I knew the colours kind of sort of like suited him. Until at one point I was leaving my underwear behind, and the partner I was with was going, you know, where's the bra that matches with that? So I was like, matching underwear is really important.